A very good evening to all of you and welcome back. In this video, we are going to learn how to make the apple and the caterpillar animation in PowerPoint. The interesting thing about this animation is how we are showing and hiding the caterpillar through the holes in the apple. I had created this animation in 2019 and after a long time, today I thought to make a tutorial that might help you to learn a few of PowerPoint's basic commands. This animation is inspired by the work of Noel Delgado at codepen.io. So, let's get started, and here I am only going to give you brief information about the objects and the animation effects that we used in this presentation. It is not quite possible to make these kinds of complex animations in PowerPoint without the help of selection and animation panes. So, to begin, we will open both the panes, one from the Home tab and another from the Animations tab. The knife and the base are static objects and we have not applied any animation effects to them. Now we will begin with the caterpillar first and we'll turn on all the caterpillar layers while hiding the rest of the other layers. You can now see only the corresponding animation effects in the Animation tab that we have applied to the caterpillar. Basically, we have used a total of 9 oval shapes for the caterpillar. 1 for the face and the rest 8 for the body. You can notice here that we have used the custom motion path effect to move the caterpillar through the apple holes. We also used the spin effect for the face as well. We are rotating the face at 135 degrees clockwise with auto reverse. The duration is 1 second with a delay timing of half a second and repeating the effect until end of the slide. Keep in mind that custom motion path can only be applied on an object through the animation drop-down menu as you will not find this effect under the Add Animation menu. Later, after drawing the path you can use the edit points through the effect options to add or remove points and to add curves in the path. The duration of this effect is 2 seconds while also repeating this until the end of the slide. Then you can copy the same oval as many times as much length you want to give to the caterpillar tail. Like, we copied the same oval 8 more times while only keeping the motion path but not the spin effect. Then we added a very short delay timing between each of the motion path effects. Now, let's look into the animation through slideshow, and there you have 9 ovals moving through the motion path with a little delay timing between each. We have drawn the apple using shapes tool and later we converted that into a picture and divided that into 2 parts, apple body and apple cropped head. Now if we turn on both these layers and see the slideshow then you can notice how the caterpillar is going in and out through the apple. The important thing here to note is the position of the objects in the selection pane. You can see that the apple head layer is beneath the caterpillar layers while the apple body is on top. So, if I turn on and off both apple layers in a time and see the slideshow then you can guess how the caterpillar is moving in and out. Also, on both apple layers, we are using the grow, shrink animation effect with 110% vertical growth with auto reverse and repeating until end of slide. The duration of this effect is also 2 seconds. Then we have 2 more layers there, left and right holes in the head. Both layers have been used to fill the white parts of the apple holes and have been placed behind the apple head and body. If I make only both these layers visible and see the slideshow then you can notice that both the layers are moving up and down. That is to match both the layers with the apple body and head as they are growing and shrinking, and we applied a very short up motion path on both the layers with auto reverse with 2 seconds duration. Lastly, we have the apple eyes in 4 different layers and if I hide the rest of the layers then you will see nothing on the slide because the eyes color is white and so does the slide background color is. So, if I change the background and see the slideshow then you can notice that both the eyes are moving up and down while growing and shrinking. We used the same up motion path and grow, shrink to move the eyes along with the apple body and head. We are using 120% and 130% growth rates with auto reverse while having a short time duration of only 0.25 seconds. The length of the motion path is the same as we used for the left and right hole in the head. Finally, if we turn on all the layers and see the slideshow, then we have this apple and caterpillar animation where we tried to create a kind of masking effect where the caterpillar is moving in and out through the apple holes. So I hope you will find this tutorial informative. Let me know your views by liking, sharing, and commenting.